Hello there, and welcome to an especially exciting adventure of Stubs. I'm James.
And I am Marc.
We just got out of the theater of seeing the continuation of Gene Roddenberry's classic Star Trek.
Mm-hmm.
Well, who directed this wonderful movie?
This wonderful, wonderful movie. Yeah. It was directed by J.J. Abrams. It was written by Roberto, Orci, and Alex Kurtzman, his frequent collaborators on projects and stuff.
That's why we had the giant red ball, huh?
Mm-hmm. We did have a giant red ball, and it wouldn't be a J.J. Abrams movie without it.
Yeah.
It was starring Chris Pine as Captain Kirk, Zachary Quinto as young Spock, Eric Bana as Romulan villain Nero, Bruce Greenwood as Pike, Zoe Saldana as Uhura, Simon Pegg as Scotty, John Cho as Sulu, Anton Yelchin as Chekov, Karl Urban as Bones, and Leonard Nimoy played older Spock.
All right, well, the movie, a lot of people think it's a reboot of the series. It's really not. It's an altered universe,
mm-hmm.
So therefore it fits in the continuity. We had a couple friends who really wanted to boycott it, especially the director of this, who didn't want to see it. He ended up, after the credits rolled, he said, "I loved it."
And yeah, he ended up really, really, really liking it.
It was a wonderful piece of film. I mean, expectations from fans were very high. It was an amazing work.
Okay. Well, I got to tell you, I went into this movie wanting to hate it because I've been a Trekkie my whole life, and I didn't like the fact that they actually asked J.J. Abrams to go in and mess around with all Gene Roddenberry's toys. And I went in there thinking, okay, I'm going to look for every continuity mistake. And about 10 minutes in, I started enjoying myself so much that I couldn't possibly.
If you ever heard the expression of pitch in a tent, that explains it all. But yeah, the expectations were high. Me, I was named after Captain James T. Kirk. But
which you
know
like
what?
To brag about a lot.
Yeah, I know I do. I think I look like William Shatner, but I am his son.
I'm glad you're proud of that.
You know, but he can have. Never mind.
He
can have his way with a couch and.
He could. Well, anyway, I had really low expectations, and I was so pleasantly surprised by how everything turned out. And yeah, like you said,
a lot of the fans were like upset. J.J. Abrams, you know, kind of ruined everything that Gene Roddenberry, you know, had created. You know, and to be honest with you, it was amazing. It really was. I'm not a big Star Trek fan. I was more Star Wars. Coming into this movie, I had very low expectations because, to be honest with you, I never really found Star Trek that appealing to me.
Yeah, he's lame.
You know, but, of course, my friends, you know, over here, him and my buddies trying to get me to watch the original series and the new stuff, so they're slowly winning me into being a Trekkie.
Big, big Trekkie. No, when I first heard about the movie, it bothered me because Nero was going to be this Romulan villain who was to come back in time, and, of course, humans didn't even meet Romulans face-to-face until Balance of Terror. That was well into Kirk's reign as Captain of the Enterprise, nothing at Starfleet, but the characters actually did explain, you know, that it was an alternate reality, like you said, and, you know, that opened up a lot of story possibilities.
Well, let's do the comparisons. From the original cast, Shatner, Nimoy.
I was really, really impressed, and I didn't think I was going to be.
You know, Chris, the breakout performance by far was, man, Karl Urban as Bones.
Karl Urban was amazing, and DeForest Kelly had such a way with McCoy. He was the gentlemanly Southern doctor, and he was just irritable and a salty old cuss, and he'd get so pissed off about everything, and Karl Urban just nailed all that, and I just really, really, Simon Pegg as Scotty, that was the one casting even before they started this movie. It was the one thing I was actually excited about, and Simon Pegg
nailed it.
Hit it out of the park. I mean, God bless Jimmy Doohan.
Zachary Quinto, who you may remember from a small little TV series called Heroes.
Okay. Every time Zachary Quinto came on his Spock, did you have to do this?
Yes, I did. I wanted him to lap somebody's head off. I wanted to eat some brains.
Yeah. Well, when I first saw the trailer, I thought, oh my gosh, that's just Sylar is Spock. It makes no sense. But when you actually see the movie, you think,
wow, he does a decent job.
He's Spock. It's just, it's amazing.
Then you had the fan casting. Bruce Greenwood as Pike.
Bruce Greenwood was awesome.
Yeah.
And there is a wheelchair that factors into the story somewhere. He's going to retire to Talos IV and live happily ever after. I do want to mention Anton Yelchin as Chekov. His performance
Anton
did...
Anton Yelchin.
Yeah.
Well,
his
cool
performance did come across as a little cartoony.
Yeah.
But...
He was still fun. I mean, he was definitely the comedic in the movie. But also, he's also playing Kyle Reese in Terminator 4.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I do want to mention my favorite Trek actor of all time was actually Marc Leonard. And that went a long way to making Sarek my favorite Trek character. And I was really, really afraid that Ben Cross wouldn't nail it like Marc Leonard did. But there's a real tender scene between him and Spock near the end of the movie where I just thought, okay, Ben Cross is definitely heir to the throne. And God bless Marc Leonard. But he did do a great job. And I was very, very happy with that. Zoe Saldana is Uhura. Very sassy. Very take charge.
Perfect. And John Chow with the fencing lessons. Phenomenal.
Doesn't have the booming voice that you come to expect from
Sulu. Yeah, Sulu, yeah. That's very good. Oh, and also, and you're wondering who Kirk is, right? And save the best for last. Okay, I remember the actor in Smoking Aces as one of the three brothers.
Oh, he was in Smoking Aces, wasn't he?
Yeah. He's the one who killed Ben Affleck. Spoiler.
That's
and he takes Ben ice. Affleck's jaw. That's Kirk. When I heard that, I was like, what?
Chris Pine, I don't know if you ever saw Bottle Shock with Alan Rickman. He was in that. He was phenomenal. If you watch Bottle Shock and then you watch Star Trek, no need for concern at all.
Yeah.
And I kind of feel bad that they didn't invite William Shatner to be in this movie as a fan. But then after seeing it, I thought, oh my gosh, maybe Shatner would have ruined it. He would have camped it up like he always does. Oh, God, did I get a tear in my eye seeing Leonard Nimoy as old Spock.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, when he meets young Kirk for the first time and then comes face-to-face with himself. The whole, I will always be your friend. Just, it still gets to me.
Well, if you want to see this movie or whether you don't, well, in our opinion, from a non-Star Trek geek, a Trekkie.
Yeah. See it!
See
oh
it.
My God, see it.
Very
I
amazing.
Never thought I'd say that. Touche, J.J. Abrams. Touche.
You and your red ball, you did it again. Well, been another. This was an most exciting
adventure.
Yeah,
this was the most exciting. Midnight shows always are, I gotta say.
Too bad we didn't do it back of the van. But oh well. But this has been Stubbs. I'm James.
And I'm Mark. But before we go, I do want to tell you again about our email address. You have a comment about what you're seeing? Shoot us an email. The address is stubsreviews@gmail.com. All right, what do you say? It's about time for us to get out of here?
Well, hold on. Ask why James shaved his beard. Could be very...
We'll talk about that
consequential
later.
...consequential about the Stubs.
They're waiting for us, okay?
All right.
Enterprise 2 to beam up.
This ship.
That's exciting.